I'm going to talk about entering a non-changing date in Excel. There's a nice function in Excel where if you enter equals now, opening bracket, closing bracket, it'll give you the date and time. This is very nice, except for that when you open it up again, it keeps changing. So it's the now, so if you open it up in 5 minutes, it will not say 6:31, it'll say 6:36. So we need to find a way to enter the date and it stays the same. So what we're going to do is in column A, so if we're doing, for example, shipments of products or something, so to create a timestamp there, a date that doesn't change, what we need to do is allow it to have a circular reference. So what we're going to do is we're going to go File and Options, and then we're going to go to Formulas, and we're going to go Enable Iterative Calculations, and we're going to go Maximum Iterations to be 1. So that will allow us to enter a formula with a circular reference, and then we're going to say OK. And now we're going to go to our A2 cell here and we're going to enter the formula. And so what we're going to do is we're going to go if and we'll go B2. So we'll select B2 and we'll go if it's not blank, then we're going to go a nested if, and we're going to go A2. It's not going to let us select it, so let's go A2. Equals nothing. Then we're going to use a function now. Opening bracket, closing bracket. And then we're going to go A2. And then we're going to close that bracket. And then we're going to put a comma, and we're going to go blank again. So we should press enter. And basically you have nothing. But if we put in a shipment number of 123, let's say, press enter. Okay, and it's put the date in a decimal format. So let's go to format. On the format cells, we'll select time and we'll say okay. So there it's entered the time. Now we can drag that down and then anytime you enter a number in here it will show you the time. So there you go, how you can enter a date that doesn't change in Excel. Please subscribe.